All people come to him, come to the way of Sultan Al-Anbiya, most honored one and most glorified one, most praised one, in divine presence, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. الحمد لله الذي هدانا للإسلام وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله، فالمنة من الله عز وجل لأنه هدانا إلى الإسلام بغير حول ولا قوة منا، ولكن المنة الحقيقية هي من الله عز وجل ومن حبيبه المصطفى عليه أفضل الصلاة والسلام، حيث خلقنا الله عز وجل من أمة الحبيب المصطفى. أما بعد، I will speak in English and then later in خطبة المسنونة في العربية على مذهب إمام أبو حنيفة النعمان، إمام أعظم هو إمامنا جميعا إن شاء الله، إمامنا جميعا. الحمد لله الذي جعلنا مسلمين. We thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى that He made us Muslims. And what more than this favor we want? If we put it in the scale, it is the heaviest that can be put in a scale, that to be a Muslim. Even you have sins, but in the other side you are a Muslim and saying istighfar, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will forgive you from your sins. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in his hadith, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان سبحان الله وبحمده سبحان الله العظيم. Two words or two sentences that they are very heavy in the scale. When he say ثقيلتان في الميزان means the most heaviest that can be possible you can imagine in your life. Everyone will think something about the heaviness. They say the mountains are the most heaviest in dunya, on the earth that we are living. Might be there are more heavier than the mountains in the universe. Allah knows best. But let us be, as in, we are in dunya living here on earth, the heaviest are the mountains. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made mountain of Uhud, as it is said in many places, that it is the heaviest of, if all the mountains are added together on one side of the scale and say, Jabal Uhud on the other side of the scale, Jabal Uhud is heaviest, heavier than all the mountains on earth. It is heavier because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala balanced the dunya when He created dunya earth. It was shaky. Allah has put mountains on it in order to balance it and make it heavy, to stay in its place. And Jabal Uhud was the heaviest to balance the earth and keep it surrendering and submitting to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not moving left or right. Only in cases that Allah wants to show His servants His punishment, He makes earthquakes. May Allah protect us from earthquakes. Amen. Prophet said, كلمتان خفيفتان على اللسان ثقيلتان في الميزان. Two words, very light on the tongue, but very heavy on the scale. Means heavier than everything that you imagine, heavier than mountains and heavier than mountain of Uhud. if you mention these two words that Allah happy with them, Subhanallah wa bihamdi, we are praising glory to Allah Subhanahu wa Taala, and thank to Allah wa bihamdi. Thaqilatani fil mizan, they are very heavy in the scale, very light on the tongue. So say Subhanallah wa bihamdihi, Subhanallah al-Azim, Subhanallah al-Azim. That these two words is enough to purify you and to clear you as a ticket to paradise. And that's why it is very important to look into the ahadith of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that contain these praises on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that Allah will forgive ibaduhu from all sins. So, man qala la ilaha illallah, and everyone knows, man qala la ilaha illallah dakhala al-jannah. Is there anything more than that to say? Even if you didn't say anything else, you said la ilaha illallah Muhammadun Rasulullah, you enter paradise. Means if you had sin, not to do sin because of you think that you are entering paradise, but sincerity to show Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah loves us, he said, say la ilaha illallah, accept me, I am the creator, and Muhammad is my messenger, you enter paradise, that's your ticket. But in paradise there are levels on how much Muslim and mu'min, different levels. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in many places that the best that you do amal is to be humble. Where he said in his hadith, ألا أخبركم بأهل الجنة؟ Do you want me to tell you about the people of paradise? The Sahaba, of course, they want to know. They said, نعم يا رسول الله. قال كل ضعيف متضعف. Every weak, humble person that he makes himself humble to everyone else, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will send that mu'min, that Muslim to paradise with no account. To be humble. So let us check ourselves. Are we humble or not? Can check by our actions. How to speak with people, how to address your family, how to address your children, how you address your parents. Are you addressing them with humbleness or are you addressing them with tyranny and fight and anger? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Ahlul Jannah الضعفاء, means the humble ones. So be humble and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you paradise. Do you want paradise?
Yes.
You want paradise?
Inshallah.
Inshallah. Inshallah we'll be in paradise.
Inshallah.
That's why one of the greatest scholars in Islam, in his munajat, supplications, he was saying, Ya Rabbi, how can I come to you? I love you. He is one of the scholars that very famous in Muslim, in Islam, Abu Yazid al-Bastami, that he was so, has so much ishq, love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So his concern is to reach, how to reach the divine presence. All of us, we are coming here to this masjid or to another masjid or to another place where the people pray and sit with them, pray with them. All our concern is that Allah to be happy with us. So then we have to ask ourselves, what are things that our ancestors they have done for us in order to follow and to be guided with what their action they did. So that Abu Yazid al-Bastami was in love with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he wants to enter his divine presence. He said, Ya Rabbi, كيف الوصول إليك? O Allah, how I can reach you? How I can come to you? I want to come to you. I'm praying, but I'm unable to see anything. I'm seeing what people are seeing. And Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in a holy hadith, hadith Qudsi, that ما زال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه فإذا أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به. Until the end of the hadith. If my servant approaches me through voluntary worshipness, I will love him. Allah is saying in Hadith Qudsi to Prophet, say to your ummah that if they approach me through voluntary worshipness, obligations, we have to do that. We are not, you cannot run out of it. You cannot run away from it. You have to do the prayer, the obligations. But to approach is to approach through voluntary worshipness, through the sunnah of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, through the good behaviors, makarim al-akhlaq, wa innaka la'ala khuluqin azim, innama bu'istu li'utammima makarim al-akhlaq, the good behaviors, you have to approach Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will be his ears that he can hear with, means that person become able to hear what people cannot hear. He will be able to see what people cannot see. وَكُنْتُ بَصَرُهُ الَّذِي يُبْصِرُ بِهِ. I will be his eyes that he can see with. I will be his tongue that he can speak with. I will be his hand that he can move things with it. I will be give him power to his feet to walk with. On Sirat al-Mustaqim. So there is that possibility of seeing and hearing. Or else Allah will not say it to Prophet and Prophet say it to the Ummah. مَا زَالَ عَبْدِي يَتَقَرَّبُ إِلَيَّ بِالنَّوَافِلِ حَتَّى أُحِبُّهُ. Period. When my servant approaches me and approaches me and approaches me through voluntary worshipness, I will love him. When Allah loves someone, finish. So Abu Yazid wants that love. And asking, Ya Rabbi, I give you my life, myself. I want to be, to see you, to hear what you cannot be heard, as you mentioned, as Prophet mentioned in that hadith, that can see things that people cannot see, to approach your divine presence, to approach at least to see Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in dream or in vision. How many of us, many people, mashallah, comes and they say, I saw Prophet in dream. How much ni'mah is that? Some people, they say more. They say they saw Allah in dream. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala appeared to Prophet in a dream, laughing to him, smiling to him. So that Abu Yazid al-Bastami was asking, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, Ya Rabbi, let me, I want to come to you. What I have to do? And he heard a voice saying, Ya Abu Yazid, you want to come to the Divine Presence? Welcome. But don't bring anyone with you. Not to bring people, no. But not to bring something that within you with you. There is something there in you that I cannot accept. That's why Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, أخوف ما أخاف على أمتي الشرك الخفي. The most I fear for my ummah is the hidden shirk. Is that? What is hidden shirk? to do something and you say, I did. No, it's Allah what He did for you as a favor. I did this, I did that. No, you cannot do this, you cannot do that. Allah gave you the power to do it. I gave fi sabilillah. I gave for a masjid. I gave for a hospital. I gave a poor person. No, you didn't do that. Allah did that for you. Allah gave you to give. So that hidden shirk, I don't want you to come with it to my presence, to that divine presence. Love has to be for one. Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has tested Sayyidina Yaqub alayhi salam with Sayyidina Yusuf? Because he was loving Sayyidina Yusuf so much that he began to forget about loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he's a prophet. Allah took his son from him, made his brothers prophets. 12 of them, they are prophets. 10 of them made them to put him in the well for someone else to take him, to test Sayyidina Yaqub alayhi salam. You come to me, don't bring something with you. You have to come alone. Your heart can contain one, not two. Two is shirk. One that you have to come with. That's why Abu Yazid al-Bastami heard a voice saying, Ya Abu Yazid, if you want to come to me, heavenly voice through angels. Allah sending, inspiring his heart to hear that. You want to come with me? اترك نفسك وتعال. Leave yourself and come. Don't come with yourself. Don't say I am Sheikh. Don't say I am Imam. Don't say I am a businessman. Don't say. Leave that for dunya and come to me مجردا عن نفسي. Completely denying and declining your ego yourself. فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا. Allah inspired the self what is good and what is bad. Don't come with what is bad. Come with what is good. And surrender to me. That's why Rabi'a al-Adawiyya, one of the famous lady in Islamic world, she said, Ya Rabbi, when her husband died and the ulama came to her and say, Ya Rabi'a, you have to get married because you don't have anyone to support you. She said, I'm busy. They said, what you are busy with? You marry, you are free, you don't have a husband now. She said, I don't have time for a husband. I'm busy. They said, with what you are busy? She said, I am busy with istighfar. I don't have time in my life, in my day and night, except to say astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. They said, no, but you have to marry. She said, I am busy. If you answer me on my questions, I will marry. When angel of death is coming to take my soul, is he coming with punishment or coming with rahmah? If you say that he is coming with rahmah, okay, I got married next day. But if you say he is coming with punishment, I am busy, I want to worship. I want to make istighfar. Can they answer? No way. No one able to answer. She said, leave that. If the angel of death in the grave, when everyone leaves me and put me in the grave, the two angels, Ankar and Nakir, when they are coming to question me, Are they coming with punishment or with mercy? If you tell me you know, then okay, I will marry. They said, yeah. Rabi'a, no one knows. She said, if no one knows, I am busy then. Are we busy today with istighfar? Inshallah. Good answer. Inshallah. Means we are not yet ready. Real istighfar. Real istighfar takes you from the level of nothing to be something. Because your presence will be appreciated in heavens. People of heaven, angels of heavens are happy when Abd do istighfar. And Allah ordered them to do istighfar on our behalf if we do istighfar. Because our istighfar is blended like a soup. But heavenly istighfar is pure. So they do that istighfar on our behalf because we are doing in dunya, blended with many other things. Allah ordered them to do for us istighfar that is clean, depending on our istighfar, to balance our istighfar. And that's why our istighfar will be accepted. She said that they come and Karwanakir with the two angels, with mercy or with punishment. Give me an answer. We don't know. There is a question mark. Are we safe? Or are we not safe? Sayyidina Muhammad alayhi afdalus salatu wassalam said to Sayyida Aisha, Ya Aisha, ask Allah not to judge you. That is the wife of Prophet ﷺ that he loves most. Say to her, in man husib, uzzib. Ya Aisha, man husib, uzzib. Anyone who will be questioned, he will be punished. Because Allah will show him something that he did in dunya wrong. That's why ask Allah not to judge you. May Allah not to judge us.
Ameen.
With the shafa'ah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So she said, in the day of judgment, Allah will call me to His presence to judge me. Is He going to call me with mercy or with punishment? I don't know. So I am busy then. Leave me alone to do istighfar. Because my amal, my prayers need to have istighfar in order that Allah will accept them. That's why after the prayer what we say? Astaghfirullah. Immediately. To make the prayer to be accepted. Because in the prayer when you say Allahu Akbar, every nonsense comes to your mind. You waste your prayer. Everything in dunya come to your mind at that moment as soon as you say Allahu Akbar. When you don't say, when you are not a prayer, shaitan doesn't come. Sheikh, sahih? Sahih. So Abu Yazid al-Bastami, he heard that voice saying to him, you want to come to me? Leave yourself. اترك نفسك وتعال. Leave yourself, your desires, your pleasures, leave them, don't come with them. Sayyidina Musa thought that he can see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because he thought that he's ready. قَالَ رَبِّ أَرِنِي أَنْظُرْ إِلَيْكَ. He had that tendency to say, let me see you. What Allah said? لَنْ تَرَانِي. لَنْ تَرَانِي. Allah, how he is going to show himself to Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. This whole dunya will not be able to get, it will shake completely if Allah sent His manifestation on it. Allah said to him, look at the mountain. If the mountain stays where it is, you can see me. فلما تجلى ربه للجبل جعله دكا وخر موسى صعقا. When Allah send His manifestation of His beautiful name and attribute on the mountain, mountain shattered completely, was not able to carry. Oh, Ummat al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyidina Musa was unable to carry that manifestation, but Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was able to carry that. Where he said, Allah in Holy Quran, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. If we reveal that Quran on a mountain, means the heart of anyone, it will break his heart, it will shatter the mountain into pieces. But Prophet did not shatter. Prophet was able to carry.
Ya Rasulullah.
Prophet was able to carry the manifestations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's beautiful names and attributes when he revealed the Holy Quran with Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam. So our duty to say that, Ya Rabbi, makes us humble, as we said at the beginning. Ahlul Jannah, Ahlul Tawadu. Ahlul Jannah, the people of Tawadu, people of humbleness. Then Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, هَلْ أُخْبِرُكُمْ بِأَهْلِ النَّارِ. Do you want me to tell you about the people of hellfire? Sahaba said, yes, Ya Rasulullah. He said, كُلُّ جَوَّاذٍ مُتَكَبِّرٍ. Everyone ignorant, arrogant. Ignorant and arrogant. How many in our life we ignore things that we don't know, and still we are proud of what we know. And Allah said in Holy Quran, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Don't think you know too much. What you have been given from knowledge, very little, drops of the ocean. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Sayyidina Abu Huraira said, that صبر رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في قلبي وعاءين أما أحدهما فبثثته للخلق وأما الآخر لو بثثته لقطع مني هذا البلعوم. سيدنا أبو هريرة said, I took from Prophet two kind of knowledges. One I shared with everyone. That's why he has lot of ahadith, سيدنا أبو هريرة, by himself, between 3,000 to 4,000 hadith. I shared with everyone. But the other one, I cannot share it. Because if I share it, they will cut my neck. Who will cut his neck in that time? He said, Prophet has given me, I learned from Prophet, حفظت عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وعائين. I memorized and I understood and I learned two kind of knowledges. One I explained completely with ahadith, as Prophet has mentioned it in his different associations, and one knowledge I kept it because if I will share it, they cannot accept it, they will cut my neck. Means there is something that is important to learn about. That's why Allah said, وَمَا أُوتِيتُم مِّنَ الْعِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. What you have given of knowledge is little bit. Allah gave علوم الأولين والآخرين that knowledge to Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do you think that Prophet needs it, or Allah gave it to him for the Ummah? Allah gave Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam for the Ummah. Whatever he gave him of knowledge is for the Ummah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the gaze of Prophet on us.
Ameen.
To bless us with that knowledge. that Sayyidina Musa were running after Sayyidina al-Khidr to give that knowledge to him. وَعَلَّمْنَاهُ مِنْ لَدُنَّ عِلْمًا. We have taught him from heavenly knowledge. So in order to end up, what is the time now? Is there time?
4 minutes.
What we need really to make, Allah wants to make us happy. Allah wants our happiness. Allah wants that His mercy be sent on us. So Prophet ﷺ said to his Sahaba a hadith that sometimes we doesn't look deep into it, but is a very strong hadith and very merciful hadith that will save us from hellfire. He said to his Sahaba and through them to us, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. If you pass by the gardens of heavens, go quickly and sit with them. Of course, Prophet want his Sahaba to know that hadith because they are practicing it with him. Sitting with Prophet is practicing that hadith. إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ. He is Riyadh al-Jannah. He is the heavenly garden. All the Ummah likes to go into his garden, is not? مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين والصديقين والشهداء والصالحين. Everyone wants to be with this group of people. So how to be with them? To sit with them is very simple. And Allah, Prophet mentioned it. إذا مررتم برياض الجنة فارتعوا. If you pass by the gardens of heavens, sit there. Means, garden of heavens, al-Rawda al-Sharifa, Rawda al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Yes.
Subhanallah.
Yes, that's the real Rawda on earth. This is garden of heaven.
Subhanallah.
That's why you see people fighting for it, to go and pray to rak'ats there. Or to pray all their prayers there. I remember myself when I was younger and was living there. Every prayer we used to pray in the Rawda. Not like now, so crowded. You cannot go in. They give you time. At that time it was easy. But alhamdulillah, more better people going there, better. Even their intention is to reach Rawda or to reach Hajar al-Asad, Aswad, and they were not able. Allah will, as if they have reached the Rawda and reached Hajar al-Aswad, Allah will write for them as a reward, not to be deprived. Give everyone the same. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wants us to be happy. He gave us a small hadith, two lines. إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا. If you pass by the gardens of heavens, sit. Like we sit in the garden of heavens in رَوْضَةٌ مَا بَيْنَ قَبْرِي وَمِنْبَرِي رَوْضَةٌ مِنْ رِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ. Between my grave and my minbar is a garden of heaven. So when you enter heaven, you don't go punishment anymore. When you enter heavens, they will not take you to hellfire. Because you entered heaven already, Allah knows. And Allah by his power make you to enter a paradise, to enter Rawdatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. A reflection from that Rawda, a reflection, Allah made a reflection as real to everyone. Because those who are living there, they are living there and they are being blessed with the Rawdah, with the presence of Prophet. That we are here, we are blessed or not? We say yes, because Allah will not let some great people be blessed and some not be blessed. We are asking, Ya Rabbi, we are in a country that is far away and we cannot reach. That's why Prophet ﷺ said to Sahaba, إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ, even if you are in Yemen or you are in Sham or you are in North Africa spreading Islam, you are passing by Riyadul Jannah. When you pass by them, sit with them, it's going to be written for you as if you are in Rawdah, a reflection from the Rawdah. قَالُوا وَمَا رِيَادُ الْجَنَّةِ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, what are these gardens of heaven, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ? He said this, حِلَقُ الذِّكْرِ, circles of remembrance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قُلْ
اللَّهِ,
Allah said in the Holy Quran, قُلْ اللَّهِ ثُمَّ دَرْهُمْ فِي خَوْضِهِمْ يَلْعَبُونَ, and leave them, don't bother with them. Those who likes to be with you can be with you. This masajid around the world where people come and sit learning and studying Hafz al-Quran, memorizing the Holy Quran, or sitting memorizing hadith, or sitting understanding fuqh or anything, or making zikrullah, or reciting Quran, or anything you they do, sit with them. That is a place that it is a paradise. Allah turn it into a paradise. قالوا يا رسول الله وما رياض الجنة يا رسول الله, قال حلق الذكر, that is a حلقة, that is a circle of ذكر الله. So you are in a paradise. Allah turn it, turn this masjid to a paradise. At that moment, how long we are sitting here, it will that long, that 1 hour or half an hour or 2 hours or 3 hours we are sitting, we are being blessed with Riyadul Jannah as if we are sitting in Riyadul Jannah. That is a rahmah min Allah Azza wa Jal li ummatun Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Is a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the benefit of the ummah. People, they might turn their faces away, say, oh, we are busy, we go Jum'ah only. No, because you are not sitting in a hall. You are sitting, not only a masjid, but you are sitting in a rawdah. It's not me, I say that, or you, Imam, you say that. It's Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam saying that. إِذَا مَرَرْتُمْ بِرِيَادِ الْجَنَّةِ فَارْتَعُوا, قال وما رياض الجنة يا رسول الله, قال حلق الذكر. When you pass by the gardens of heavens on earth, sit with them, because there are angels. We are not able to see them, but Prophet mentioned that there are angels encircling us, encircumambulating us, in circles all the way to heavens. ما جلس قوم يذكرون الله إلا حفتهم الملائكة وغشيتهم الرحمة وذكرهم الله في من عنده. As long as my servant sit together in zikr, remembering me, angels will be encircumambulating and will be encircling them up to paradise. That place become a rawdah. Rawdah on the level, not rawdah to Nabi as Prophet, but a reflection of that rawdah will be that 2 hours or that 1 hour will be written for you as if you were sitting there. Allah generous can write for you forever to sit in rawdah. To sit in rawdah forever, you sitting there, your soul is there, your body is here. Why not? Can be done that? If Allah wants, can do it or not?
Yes.
Let us say, Ya Rabbi, do it for us. We are benefiting, not to ignore it. So that's why Hilaq al-Zikr are very important in our life. So let us thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَلَئِن شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. If you thank me, I give you more. And there is a lot of more. This is one hadith about such kind of associations. People come and people go, and you benefit from their presence because they make the masjid alive. And that circle become alive by zikrullah, by remembering Allah, Allah turns it into a rawda. What we need more than that? Say, this is a gift from Allah to you, to Ummatul Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, because he loved his servant Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. May Allah forgive us.
Amen.
May Allah accept from us.
Amen.
Accept from all of you.
Amen.
And turn this masjid, inshallah, all the time to Rawda min Riyad
al-Jannah.
Amen. Hurmat al-Habib wa Hurmat al-Fatiha. Yeah.